हेलो, वेलकम टू दिस चैनल गेन जावा नॉलेज। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न व्हाट इज सोनार क्यूब एंड हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट इन अवर स्प्रिंग बूट एप्लीकेशन एंड व्हाई वी नीड सोनार क्यूब। सो ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट फर्स्ट विद व्हाट इज सोनार क्यूब। सोनार क्यूब इज एन ओपन सोर्स प्लेटफॉर्म टू परफॉर्म ऑटोमेटिक रिव्यू विद स्टैटिक एनालिसिस ऑफ कोड। एंड सोनार इज एन ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी प्लेटफॉर्म एंड सोनार यूजेज वेरियस स्टैटिक एंड डायनामिक कोड एनालिसिस टूल सच एज चेकस्टाइल, पीएमडी, फाइंडबग्स एंड मेनी मोर। सो एज वी नो, सोनार क्यूब इज स्टैटिक कोड एनालिसिस टूल। सो व्हाट इज स्टैटिक कोड एनालिसिस? तो स्टैटिक कोड एनालिसिस मीन्स कंप्यूटर कोड दैट इज परफॉर्म्ड विदाउट एक्चुअल एग्जीक्यूटिंग प्रोग्राम्स एंड सोर्स कोड विल बी चेक्ड फॉर कंपाइलेंस विद ए प्री डिफाइंड सेट ऑफ रूल्स और बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस सेट बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। एंड सोनार क्यूब आल्सो चेक द डुप्लीकेशन ऑफ कोड, लैक ऑफ यूनिट टेस्ट केसेस, पोटेंशियल बग्स एंड नो कोडिंग स्टैंडर्ड इफ वी आर नॉट फॉलोइंग दैट विल बी चेक्ड बाय सोनार क्यूब। एंड व्हाई वी नीड सोनार क्यूब? बिकॉज कोड क्वालिटी इज एन एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर फॉर सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी डिलीवरेबल एंड अफेक्ट्स द ओवरऑल सक्सेस ऑफ ए सॉफ्टवेयर। तो सोनार क्यूब इज यूज टू डिटेक्ट द बग्स, कोड स्मेल्स एंड सिक्योरिटी वल्नरेबिलिटीज बिफोर एग्जीक्यूटिंग द प्रोग्राम। इट हेल्प्स टू फिक्स द इश्यूज एज सून एज दे अपीयर बिफोर एग्जीक्यूटिंग आवर एप्लीकेशन। एंड इट इज यूज टू कीप कोड क्लीन, सिंपल एंड इजी टू रीड एंड अंडरस्टैंड। ओके, नाउ वी विल सी हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट सोनार क्यूब इन अवर स्प्रिंग बूट प्रोजेक्ट। सो फर्स्ट वी विल क्रिएट वन स्प्रिंग बूट प्रोजेक्ट। सो हियर आई विल गो एंड ओपन स्टार्ट डॉट स्प्रिंग डॉट आई एंड हियर वी नीड टू डिफाइन द प्रोजेक्ट, माय ओन प्रोजेक्ट एंड लैंग्वेज इज जावा। एंड हियर वी जस्ट नीड टू एड ग्रुप आईडी। सो हियर in this project I will just create one simple rest endpoint that will return string value and artifact id will be sonar cube demo. So here I will just add one dependency that is spring web, and here we can see we are using java version 11 and packaging is jar. Now here I will go to the folder and will extract here and open this and copy the path and go to Eclipse, and here we just need to import existing Maven project, and here I will paste the path and finish. So it's importing the Maven project. Here our Spring Boot project has imported. We also need to download Sonar Cube jar file. So what I will do? So here I will go to Sonar Cube and close this one. And here I will click on download. So here we need to select the version, download free. So here I will click on this. So here we can see four types: community version, developer, enterprise and data center. We are going to use download for free. And when we will click on this, your download will start in few seconds. So download has been started. So here I have already downloaded and I have extracted this zip file and folder has created. So now we will go inside this folder and now need to go inside bin folder. And here we need to select our OS. So I will go to Windows 64-bit, and to start our sonar we will click on batch file start sonar.bat and it will start, and the default port for this sonar will be 9000. So here it's showing me some error because my sonar has already up. So I will go and check here at port number localhost 9000, and here we can see my port number 9000 is already up and snore is running. And here we can see there is no project, so we need to add the project. So when we first time start this batch file, it will ask for the username and password, and default username and password will be admin admin. Then we will can update the password after first login. It will enforce for update the password when we will do first time login. Then we will again login with the new credentials, and we can see the screen like this. So now I will go to Spring Boot project, and here I will create one REST endpoint. So here I will go and create one new package. That will be controller package, and here I will create one class inside this package. That will be message controller, and inside message controller I will create one class, one REST endpoint, and need to define annotation REST controller and request mapping annotation. That will be the base path for all the API. So that will be message, and here I will just create one REST endpoint. That will be get type. So here I will use get mapping, and here it will be public string get message. And here I will create one more class, that is service class, and here I will refresh it. So need to create one more package, that is service package. So here I will just define dot service, and here I am not creating any implementation or interface. Message service implementation, and here I will just define add grid service annotation. And now I will go to my controller class. So this is my controller class, that is message controller. And here what I will do, we need to import our class, that is service layer, message service impl. Now I will call the method service dot get message, and it will return the string value. So create the method get message inside service implementation layer, and here what I will do, here I will just write the code, few lines of code. So first I will declare string str is equal to gain java knowledge, and next what I will do, create one method get object, and here I will just return the value, that will be object obj. So here what I will do, create method get object, and it will return string value. So it will return null. And after getting this object, what I will do, here I will call object dot toString, object dot toString method. So what it will do, it will throw null pointer exception, and we are not handling any, we are not adding any null checkpoint. And I will just copy this and we'll paste it here, string, and returning the same value. Our REST endpoint is ready. Now what we need to do, now we need to add few dependency inside our pom.xml. So how we can implement Sonar and Gecko in our Spring Boot project, what we need to do, we need to add two dependencies. So here I will add two plugins. So here I will just add these two plugins. So I will go inside plugins and we'll just paste these two plugins. So here we can see I have added two plugins, one for Sonar and one for Jokeco. That is Sonar Maven plugin I have added with version 3.8.0, and second I have added the plugin for Jokeco Maven plugin, that is 0.8.5 version. And here I have set the execution is prepare agent and the goal is report also. So here we can see we will use Jokeco Maven plugin, that is Jokeco Maven plugin, and its report is report goal to create a code coverage report, because we want to create a specific profile with executes JUnit test cases. So it will use the Jokeco agent and creates a coverage report with the help of this plugin. And by default the generated report will be go inside our target folder. Inside target there will be one more folder will be generate when we will execute. Inside the target there will be site and jokeco.xml file will be create. So that will be automatically find by the Sonar Jokeco plugin. So no further configuration we need to add. So what I will do, we just need to execute our command. So first I will update as Maven update project, because it's showing some red sign here at project level. So just click on force update and update it. Now what I will do, here we can see this is our Sonar dashboard, and here we can see no project is added. If I will refresh it, so we can see no project is here. So what I will do, first I will execute this Maven plugin command. So I will copy it and go to my project and run as Maven build, and here we just need to add this command. So I have deleted all the previous configuration. So now I will just click on run as Maven build. So here it will ask for goal. I will just add clean org Jokeco Maven plugin prepare agent install and apply it and run. So here we can see on the console. So test cases are going execute, but we have not write any test case yet. So our command has executed successfully. Now we need to refresh it. So here we can see inside target folder, our site folder has created and Jokeco, and inside Jokeco, Jokeco.xml file has created and it will be automatically picked by Sonar dashboard. So now what I will do, I will execute Sonar command. So here I will go, and first we need to get the token. So to get the token we need to create here and click on my account, and here we just need to go on security, and inside security we just need to enter the token name. So I will use enter token name, we can add any value. So here I have added admin and token has generated. Now just need to copy and go here, and I just need to replace. So now I will copy this, and now I will go to our Eclipse and click on run as Maven build again, and here we need to add the goal and apply and run. So our build has created successfully. Now I will go, first we need to refresh it. Now I will go to browser and will refresh it and go to projects. So here we can see our project has ended. So this is our project name, Sonar Cube Demo. Here we will click and see inside our code there is one bug and zero vulnerability issue and zero security issue, and here we can see the code coverage is 27%. So first I will check the bugs. So we just need to click on bug number one. So here we can see a null pointer exception could be thrown by object is nullable here. So here it's also showing the code of line where will be the bug is raised. So we just need to resolve this issue. So what we can do, we will go here and go to our code, that is source main Java, and go to our service implementation, and here I will just return one value abc. So now I will again execute sonar colon sonar command, run as maven build, and sonar colon sonar, and click on OK. So once the build will create successfully, we need to check it again on sonar dashboard. So build is created successfully. Now I will go to sonar dashboard on browser and will refresh. So here I will go to projects, and here we can see, it's showing sonar cube demo failed. Why it's showing failed? It's showing failed due to because its quality gate status is failed. So we need to check our quality gates. So by default it's picking up sonar way, and there are multiple conditions. Our code coverage should be more than 80%, not should be less than its 80%, and duplicate lines is greater than 3%. If any condition fail, then it will show the status as failed. So here I will use this gate as the default quality gate. So now I will again go and check it. So I think I need to rerun the command, that is sonar sonar run as maven build. Because the quality gate status should be passed, must be passed, and inside this gates quality gate we can check the condition, which condition we have applied. So now I will refresh it once the build will be created successfully. So now go to browser and refresh it again. So here we can see the quality gate status has passed, and now we will go to our quality gates that we have created manually. And here I have just added coverage less than 10%, then only it will be failed. So we can add multiple conditions by click on this. So if we will click here, we can see line coverage, lines to cover, uncovered lines, duplication code, any condition we can add here. So now I will go back to projects, and now our code is looking fine. So if you want to increase the code coverage, then we need to write the test cases. So now I will go to my project, and here I will go to source main test. And inside this folder, one class is already created, demo application test. And here I will just add the rate test annotation, and we'll write one method public. So no need to use public, void test get message. So here what I will do, we need to import at the rate auto add controller message controller, we need to import, and controller, now copy this controller, and we just need to call get message. So it will return the value. So here we can check assert. So here we just need to import the assertion, and Jupyter API assertion, click on finish. So now I will again execute the command run as maven build sonar sonar with token value, and then again we will check the sonar dashboard. So we need to check the pod coverage is increased or not. So now first I will refresh it, and we also need to execute the command that is used to generate the Jakeco report, that is clean. So here we can see tests run to build success. Now refresh it and again need to run the command that is sonar sonar. So now I will execute this command, and after that we will check sonar dashboard and we'll see the pod coverage percentage again. First it was 27%. So build is created successful. Once refresh it and go to sonar dashboard and refresh the screen and go to browser, and here we can see now code coverage is 81.8% and duplication code is 0%, and there is no bug and no vulnerability issue. So go here, click on sonar cube demo, and here we can see our overall code, and just click on lines of code. So here we can see our all classes and how much coverage is done by our sonar and Jakeco code coverage report. So this was all about our sonar cube and Jakeco code coverage report. Okay, thanks for watching this video.